How can you easily automate your work in Microsoft Excel without using macros or programming? Hi, I'm Don Bjork, the Software Pro. I'm also a Microsoft Certified Trainer and Certified Excel Expert. Microsoft Excel includes a number of built-in automation features, including AutoComplete, AutoCorrect, and AutoCalculate. You've likely used the AutoComplete feature anytime you're filling in a list of data. For example, when you start typing an entry, here I want the supply room, Excel will try to autocomplete, that is, suggest from the available responses that are already in that column. And if this is what I want, I can simply hit enter. If it's not, we can keep typing. That works great when these are unique entries. What happens when you have really similar entries? This might mean that you're having to type a lot of characters for you to finally get to that unique entry. And this can be very time consuming, especially when you have lengthy notes or comments. Let's say, for instance, we want to reference a particular conference room. Well, there's multiple conference rooms and they all begin with that phrase. So here's the other way to approach it. To get that list of options, rather than trying to type, press Alt and the down arrow key. All you have to do, Alt and the down arrow key. Here's a list of all of the unique entries in that column. We can simply select the one we want, and we're done. Another way to get that list is to instead right-click on the cell and choose Pick from drop-down list. It's the same as pressing Alt and the down arrow key. You can either use your mouse to navigate to it, or you can use your arrow keys, and then simply enter or select the one that you want. And that's how we can leverage the autocomplete for faster data entry. AutoCorrect is another quick way for us to be able to easily enter in data. You may have noticed this as you start typing. For instance, I'll do T-E-H as in the. And as soon as we hit a space, punctuation, or the enter key, then Excel will check this against its list of already existing corrections. Now, most of these are spelling errors, and it will fix it for us. And in this case now, we have then the corrected entry for this word. But we can also leverage this to create like a shorthand for lengthy entries we might enter in, such as our department name or organization name. Let's look at how we can work with the AutoCorrect feature. We'll find this under the File tab. Next, move to Options. From here, select Proofing, and then AutoCorrect Options. Proofing is not only for spelling, but also for some of these other built-in features. You'll notice here some of the characteristics here where Excel will try to fix some of your entry in terms of capitalization. But the AutoCorrect feature that we're going to focus on is replace text as you type. The list on the left-hand side tends to be spelling errors. That here's what you might type, and here's what we'll fix. And we've got over 500 entries that are built in. But we can put in our own variations here. I'm going to create just a shorthand here. Now, be careful not to use any acronyms that you might actually use, but it could be a variation, your own version of that shorthand. And this is what I want Excel to do. That is, every time I type in the shorthand, replace it with this entry. I'll add it, and we could build others. For now, though, I'll simply OK out, come back to my worksheet, and keep in mind that this is something that's used by the entire system, so it's not just for this one worksheet. Now I'll put in that shorthand, and it can be included in a larger entry, and as soon as I hit enter or a space bar, Excel will spell it out for me. How could you save time with data entry by using AutoCorrect? AutoCalculate is a great Excel feature that lets you quickly check totals, averages, and much more. Although it doesn't actually build calculations or formulas, it can be a quick auditing tool. Simply select the range that you want to work with. Next, look in your status bar at the bottom here, and you will see the average, count, and sum of the selected range. If this isn't displaying for some reason, or you even want to leverage more from AutoCalculate, simply right-click on your status bar and notice near the bottom here, we have additional options. The check mark indicates which of these are currently enabled. And so if you wanted to, for instance, also see the minimum, you could select that and it becomes another part of this AutoCalculate. So this is not something you have to turn on. It is just automatically there as part of how you are viewing that selected range. How can you take advantage of these automatic features in Excel? Now you've seen how to save time and effort by leveraging the automation tricks in Excel. For more tips and shortcuts on being productive with Excel, head to thesoftwarepro.com/Excel. If this training was helpful, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to this channel. This is Dawn Bjork, the Software Pro. Thanks for watching.